Hey, I'm Vincent Napoli, and I'm a combat designer on the multiplayer. So there's been a lot of ideas, I think, from the previous God of War games that it didn't quite make it or didn't quite fit. And I think one of the best aspects of multiplayer is we've been able to kind of revisit some of those ideas where they maybe didn't fit with Kratos or they just didn't fit in the overall scope of the game. We've been able to kind of reuse some of that. So it's kind of nice grabbing some old concepts that we knew were pretty solid and using those to kind of get started on building an allegiance or building an ability. And we've even included a lot of like fan service from some of the previous God of Wars. You might see some of the original weapons that Kratos was using kind of pop up in multiplayer and have abilities that are very similar to what you're used to. So it really helps kind of expand the universe as a whole, I think, which is cool. So players have the option of picking between four different allegiances. And what we really wanted to kind of capture with each allegiance was sort of a common play style that the classes that people like to play in everything from RPGs to shooters. And so with Zeus, for example, you have your magic-based, heavy damage, sort of almost like your mage or caster kind of character. And in contrast with Hades, you have sort of a sneakier, stealth sniper kind of class. And then with Ares, you have your sort of physical powerhouse. And all the abilities and the perks and magics all change based on which class you select to really help sell the different roles that you can play with each allegiance. Well, the newest gameplay mode that we've just announced and actually is live on beta, I think as of yesterday maybe, is Capture the Flag. And what's cool about that mode is that it's sort of a unique spin on a mode that everyone sort of appreciates and likes. And what's cool about our Capture the Flag in general is that the world, you kind of traverse the world in a very different way than you would in like most shooters. And you can really sort of work with your team to kind of protect your buddies or work against them. And the pace of our game and sort of the layout lets you really kind of understand what's going on a lot better. So when the enemy has the flag or when you have the flag, you've got plenty of time to kind of get a lay of the land, see what's going on. You really feel like you can protect the guy who has the flag as opposed to him just getting, you know, sniped off camera or something like that, which is usually the case in most shooters. You can really, you know, you can defend him, you can block him, you can heal him, you can put shields on him. And so it's a real team-oriented mode, I think, which is cool because a lot of our mechanics kind of really shine when they're put in a sort of a team scenario. Well, I think there's always stuff that we want to include that we don't have, maybe not enough time to get polished or not enough time to get refined. And we didn't go very far on stuff that we didn't include because we didn't want to, you know, everything we basically started we took to completion and kind of polished up. There are ideas left on the table that we're definitely going to try to include in future expansions or DLC stuff that I think people will like.